stress is a psychological and physiological reaction of your mind and body, and it happens when the demands from your external and internal environment, they exceed your capacity to deal with them. When a stressor is there, when a demand is there, the mind and body, they conjure up all resources to deal with it. If it is successful, the stress goes away, and in the process, your resilience, that means your ability to deal with stress, it increases further. That's how we grow. So some amount of stress is essential for our growth and it goes good for us. The problem happens when the demands are excessive or they are happening for a very long time, or if in the process the capacity or your resilience is exhausted. It is at that time stress, as we understand in layman terms, manifests and a breakdown happens, leading to negative mood and behavioral changes in the kids, including problem with memory, concentration, focus and attention, leading to poor scholastic feedback, poor behavioral feedback from school, poor falling grades in school, problems with appetite, problems with sleep, recurrent infections, headaches, aches and pains. In nutshell, it starts affecting the kid in almost all spheres of life and can actually lead to frank anxiety, to frank depression, to drug use, to substance use, to many other mental health and behavioral problems. So it is very, very important to identify this kind of a negative stress so that its complications can be prevented. There are multiple factors that can cause stress in kids. The most important being dysfunctional family environment. A family environment where parents are often quarreling with each other, fighting with each other, or they are going through separation or divorce. Research has shown that this kind of environment takes a toll on kids. Another important reason is death of a parent or a loved one. That also put a kid under a lot of stress. Then peer pressure, overburdening with activities, and the rat race phenomena. What is that? That is not wanting to be different from others, either from the kid's side or the unrealistic expectations of the parents to wish their kid become like customized geniuses in anything he or she indulges in. And last but not the least, we must remember that perception of stress is a subjective phenomenon. So what is stressful for one particular kid may not be that stressful for the other. So internal, personal, temperamental factors and perception are also very important determinants of stress. See, to identify stress at the earliest in kids, first of all, as a parent, you need to have a connect. You need to have an emotional connect with your kid, along with care and concern and an ability to see things from their perspective. That's the way you understand them better, thereby increasing chances that as and when stress will happen, you will be able to recognize the signs of stress in your kids. We need to understand another important aspect as well. See, kids and teens, they do not often understand and verbalize stress as we adults do. So most of the time, it is manifested by the changes in their mood and behavior. So as a parent, if you are cautious enough and connected enough, you will be able to notice these signs in your kids. And the signs are, number one, your kid has started turning very irritable or moody, has lost interest in activities which earlier provided him a lot of joy, having poor sleep, sleeping too much or too little, having repeated nightmares, is eating too much or too little, is throwing a lot of tantrums, is crying or yelling often, is often in a worry mode, is complaining more than usual about things, or has gone back to a less mature kind of behavior like thumb sucking or bad wetting. In case of teens, you have to be on the guard if you notice that the teen has started turning very avoidant or seclusive, or is showing erratic friendship patterns, or the teen is turning hostile towards family members, often displaying a lot of irritability and aggression. That indicates that the teen might be going through a lot of stress. Another important thing to remember is that in kids, stress can also manifest as physical complaints, like recurrent stomach aches and headaches. So if your kid is having recurrent aches and pains and the medical examination, including the medical reports, are normal, and if the complaints are happening in connection to a stressful life event in the life of the kid, like before a big exam, like when the school is changed, or like when the parents are going through separation or divorce, it may indicate that the kid is somatizing stress and expressing stress through the body. Kids at times also indirectly talk about stress when they talk negative about themselves or the world in general. Like nothing is good, nothing is fun, nobody loves me, I'm not good enough, etc. You can also have a cautious note regarding the stress in kids, and you can be in touch with reliable people in touch with your kid to know how the kid is behaving with outside people and kids. Sometimes they act out differently with people outside. So it's a good idea to have regular feedback from reliable people in touch with your kid, so that if you can get a clue about the behavior or problems or signs of stress, you can further work upon it. Here at the Department of Psychiatry and Behavioral Sciences, Saket City Hospital, believe that the best way to cure a problem is not to let it happen in the first place. So we talk about preventive mental health. In fact, we have launched the first of its kind preventive mental health screening program for kids and teens in the country. In this program, we conduct seminars, workshops in the community, in schools, to sensitize people regarding the importance of mental health. And we impart skills to teachers and parents to recognize problem behavior, common mental health issues, and signs of stress in kids. Once it is done, we provide a comprehensive preventive mental health screening program or checkup at our hospital for the kids and teens, so that a suitable management plan is laid out and the problems can be nipped in the bud and the complications can be prevented. I hereby take this chance to request you all to understand the importance of mental health and to give it the respect it deserves. I request all teachers, parents, community members, leaders to partner with us in making mental health care accessible and feasible to our kids and teens, so that nothing can come in the way of their beautiful smiles and dreams. Let's holistically heal our kids and strive to build a better world.